In Module 3, I will share more information about how to deploy Advisor in an advisor-only environment. I'll show you what are the steps involved and how to download and run the Advisor installer. Just to refresh our memory, I'd like to go back to the high-level architecture diagram and point out that we're only working in the environment on the left, the one made up of Advisor gateways and Advisor agents. So we will see how we need to install the gateway and agent components. Later on, in a future module, I'll show you how to install Advisor in the Operations Manager environment. So these are the steps that you need to perform to install Advisor at a glance. You basically need to install gateways and agents using the Advisor setup. We'll also need to download a registration certificate to identify ourselves as a user. We'll copy the files to whichever machine needs to be turned into a gateway or an agent. And once we're running the Advisor setup, we'll choose the appropriate installation. So now I'm going to move into a different machine where I'll show you how to deploy Advisor on its own. So we're back at the System Center Advisor page. And at this point, I'm going to try and create an account instead of signing in with an existing one. When I select Create an Account, I am once again given the option to create it with a Microsoft account or with an organizational account. And I'm going to reuse the demo account that I've been using and log in. And at this point, I will be taken back to the Advisor portal. And Advisor will detect that my Microsoft account already has an Advisor account called Contoso, and it's just making sure that I'm okay with creating a new account. This is very useful for teams that want to use the same Microsoft account or organizational account, but would like to segregate environments that are not related. So I'm going to call this account Advisor NVA, and Advisor already knows my name and last name from the previous account I've created. I'll go ahead and create this particular account. And at this point, all I need to do is read and accept the subscription agreement for Advisor, which I've read and accepted. And at this point, my new account is created, and I can begin deploying Advisor. I'm going to select Begin Deployment, and we're taken to the Advisor Deployment Wizard, which starts with a familiar image. It's very similar to the high-level architecture image we've shown you earlier in this presentation, and it's letting the user know that Advisor can be installed by itself or with System Center Operations Manager. Since we've already explained this, I'll move on. At this screen, we can download setup and the certificate needed to install the Advisor gateways and agents. So I'll click Download Setup and Save, and I will click Download Certificate and save that as well. And the certificate will identify me as a user and will help me associate the gateway and the agent I'm going to install to this particular Advisor account. So once that is complete, I will open my downloads folder and I will find the Advisor setup and the registration certificate. I will double click the Advisor setup and run it. And while this is happening, I'll let you know what's going on in the background and what checks Advisor is doing to ensure a successful installation. Once the Advisor Setup Wizard appears, we can click Next to read the license agreement and accept it. I can select where to install System Center Advisor. And at this point, I can select whether to make this computer a gateway or an agent. Anytime you would like to make a machine a gateway or an agent, you simply need to copy the Advisor setup download to that particular machine and run Advisor setup. So for this particular computer, I'd like it to be a gateway and an agent. And once I select gateway, the setup will let me know that the agents and the gateways will communicate through port 80, which I'm okay with. And I'm also going to make this server an agent, since it's the only one I'll be using in the demo. Once that is complete, I will click Next and I'm ready to install. And at this point, Advisor is first going to check if this computer already has the System Center Management Service, which is the name for the Operations Manager agent that runs underneath the Advisor agent. I've already installed it in this computer, but if you don't have it, the Advisor setup will allow you to install it and it will only take a couple of minutes. Since I already have it, I'm only going to need to close the application and attempt to restart them. At this point, the Advisor setup will stop my system center management service and will copy the new files that contain the agent and the gateway information needed to have Advisor on my machine. And once that is complete, it will restart the system center management service so that monitoring can continue. If you were already monitoring this computer with Operations Manager, the Advisor setup would simply create a second Operation Manager management group so that the System Center Advisor agent could live separately. Now that the Advisor setup wizard is complete, I can finish it. And since I've installed a gateway on this computer, I also need to configure it so that it can communicate with the Advisor service. And to do that, all I need to do is provide the location of the registration certificate that I just downloaded. And I can also specify if I need a proxy server to access the Advisor web service, which I don't. And I can also restrict connections to this particular gateway to a specific set of agents. I don't need to do that in the demo, but if you'd like to, all you need to do is check this box and then add the computer account for each agent to the local security group allowed Advisor agents. I will go ahead and uncheck that and click Next. Once I review my settings, I am ready to commit. And at this point, the Advisor Configuration Wizard will go through the complete configuration checklist to make sure that this gateway is ready to communicate with the Advisor service. While this is happening, I'll guide you through the different steps that are happening here. And the first thing is we're applying security settings. We're also checking proxy server settings, if any were specified. Like I agreed to, we're going to open port 80 for the agent connection, and then we'll begin starting the Advisor gateway. Now at this point, the Advisor Configuration Wizard is registering the service principal name. In this step, the Advisor Gateway will register an instance of the Advisor service so that they can communicate. If this step fails at any point, I will receive the appropriate error message letting me know that this error will prevent other agents in other computers in the network from communicating with this particular gateway. And I will be prompted to an Advisor help document that will help me correct it. After this step is complete, we're going to validate connection to the Advisor service to make sure that it is up and running and that the gateway can communicate with it. We're going to then register the gateway and the agents with the Advisor service. And at that point, we should be able to see the gateway and the agent we just installed under the Advisor Portal Server section. Once these are registered, Advisor Configuration Wizard will check settings with Operations Manager and will apply final gateway server settings, and then it will start the Advisor agent. Once that is complete, Advisor will validate agent connection to the gateway, and our configuration will be complete. After this is done, one additional step you can do is you can enable Microsoft Update to run after closing the wizard to check if there have been any more recent updates to the Advisor installer. Since I just installed this, I know that I have the latest information, but it's always recommended to check Microsoft Update. Now that the Advisor Configuration Wizard has completed, I'm ready to go back to the portal and start getting configuration assessment for my agent. This is the Microsoft Update checkbox that I mentioned earlier. For the purposes of this demo, I'm going to uncheck it since I know I have the latest bits. I can now close down the deployment wizard since I've installed my gateway and I've installed my agent. And what I'd like to do now is go to my server section and check that I now have a new gateway and a new agent reporting under Advisor. So back in the browser, in the Advisor portal, I'll go to the server section. And I can now see my gateway and my agent that I just installed for my Advisor MVA account. And that is all you need to do to install an Advisor gateway and agent on its own. If you ever need to run the Advisor deployment wizard again, all you need to do is go to the overview page in the Learn About section and click Setting Up System Center Advisor. Once you click that, you'll go back to the wizard and you can go to the second page where you can download setup and download the certificate.